Hello everyone, and welcome back to the Caves and Cliffs Part 1 Recap. This is Part 2 of the recap, not Part 2 of the update. So, we have another new item, and this is called the Spyglass. And this is made with 2 copper ingots and 1 amethyst shard, and the crafting recipe looks... It's either like that, or like that. One of the two, but it uses 2 copper ingots and 1 amethyst shard. You can use the recipe book in the crafting table to make it, and it's pretty easy. And it looks really cool when you're using it in third person, but it's also really cool when you use it, like, in first person, when you're looking at things. This is not part of, well, what I'm about to show you is not part of the game, like vanilla, but if you have Optifine, you can use the spyglass. And then you can use your zoom key, and you can zoom in even more. So let's say I want to look at that llama, but it's still a little too far away. Well, now it's right there. Hello! So this is really useful if you want to have like a roleplay, like a pirate roleplay. That would be interesting. Or if you don't have Optifine, you don't want to use Optifine, you can't use Optifine, but you still want to have a way to zoom. Spyglass. And they're not too hard to get, as long as you find an amethyst geode, and that should be easy if you explore the caves quite a bit, and copper is always easy to find. Plus, you don't even need fortune to get multiple. It's kind of like redstone. If you mine it, chances are you're going to get at least 2. Okay, now let's get on to some of the mobs. And these are the only 2 mobs that have been added in the game. Wait, there's 3. I forgot. This right here is, well, that right there is a goat. And there's also this goat, and that goat, and that goat, and that goat. And they also have babies. They also jump really high up in the air. Let's just see if we can catch one, because they look really funny when they do it. They can also jump, I think they can jump up to 10 blocks in the air. And that's pretty cool. They kind of just sit there for a second, and then they decide to jump. So it's kind of random, but hopefully we'll be able to see it. But while we wait for that, they also ram enemies. So if we get a cow over here, and a bunch of cows, and a bunch of goats, then you might see that the goats will kind of ram the cows and like hit them across the world. Not across the world, but you see what I mean. The goats kind of have like a charge attack. So they'll like get in position, they'll kind of like look down a bit, and they'll charge at it, and it'll ram it, and it'll hit it, and it'll go flying off the mountain. It's really funny to watch, but doesn't happen too often, so that's kind of a shame. Let's see if we can get this goat to ram it. You know, they're in their own little area. Maybe they'll do it, maybe they won't. Come on. Oh, look at them jumping. That was cool. So they can jump pretty high. I've been waiting here for about 5 minutes, and they have not hit any of them, and I'm getting kind of sad, because it's really funny. Dude, that's it. That's what they do. It's really funny. They can also do it to players, but I don't want to wait another 5 minutes for it to hit me off a cliff and then kill me. So that was the goat. They can also walk on powdered snow. They will not sink. And that's pretty much all they do. I mean, you can breed them. They can also kill mobs if they hit them enough. But let's see the next mob, which is the glow squid. Oh, hold on. There we go. I wanted to turn off dynamic lighting because these don't actually light up the place around you, but it's more of like an emissive texture where it looks like they're glowing, but they don't technically give off light. But they look really cool. And what they do is when you kill them, they will drop glow ink sacks. And you can craft a glow ink sack with an item frame to make a glow item frame. And it makes the item more visible in the item frame when it's dark. So let's get a normal one. And you can see they look a little... Oh my god. Okay. Well, you can see this one is a little bit darker, and this one is a little brighter, because that's what the glow item frame does. But If you get a sign, let's get a crimson sign, and you can get any color dye. Let's do lime. Dude, stop. Not, no. Okay, whatever. If you get a sign, write something. Glow squids are cool, no matter what you say. That's cool. You can right click with a dye. This was available in 1.14, but now, if you get a glow ink sack and you right click it, glow and behold, now it glows. And you can do that with any of the colors. Let's get some more dyes. You can do yellow, light blue, black, pink, green, red. You can see they all look different and they all have that outline. I think that one looks really cool. But that's the glow squid. You can also find it in caves, in the water. And the next mob is my favorite feature in all of Minecraft. Not just favorite mob, but favorite anything in the game, the axolotl. They also kill glow squids, but they come in 5 different colors. Let's see if we can. So that's one of them, cyan. That's one of them, yellow. We got brown. Then we have pink. I think it's called Lucy. I don't know why. But there's also a rare axolotl, which is a 1 in, I think, 1,200 chance to spawn. So chances are we're not going to find this anywhere. But, you know, I'll spawn a few. No, I don't think we're going to get one. I think chances are we're just going to spawn a bunch of regular, easy-to-find axolotls. We're not going to be able to find this rare blue one. Dude! Wait! Oh, I've never actually seen this guy in-game. This is my first time seeing him. Wait! I wanna... Oh! I'm taking him! Dude, look at him! He's like a blue! So this one's like a teal and like a pinkish cyan. But this one's blue and it has like orange and it's so cool. If I pick it up, there he is! And I think we have infinite. We have infinite beautiful ones. Oh, they look so cool. Oh, dude. And they're rare too. So you can find these naturally in the world, except in 1.17.1, that will change. You will only be able to breed these. So, if you get a tropical fish, or I think they only work with the buckets. I don't think I can use these. Yeah, no. But if you get a bucket of tropical fish, you can get these, and they will, there we go. We can kind of, oh, hello? We can breed the two, and they will fall in love, and they will make a baby. Chances are this one will also be the blue one. Yeah, but if we breed one of that one, and let's say that one, then chances are it'll either be brown or it'll be pink. And that's kind of how the breeding thing works. But there's also a 1 in 2,000 chance. 1 in 100. Ah! There is a 1 in 1,200 chance that you will get a blue one spawning. But that is the axolotl. They are my favorite animal in real life and my favorite feature in Minecraft. And there's nothing they can do to top that. Ever. I'm not going to show these next features, but I am going to read them out. And I will sit here with my axolotl friends. I'm going to turn down their volume because that is a lot of axolotl noises that I will have to hear. But let's read them out. So, a shulker hitting a shulker with a shulker bullet can make a new shulker. And that sounds confusing, but pretty much, if a shulker shoots one of the shulker bullets and it hits a different shulker, then there is a chance that it will create a third shulker. So that is a way to farm shulkers, so now we have renewable shulker shells, and that's pretty cool. Additions to Wandering Trader and the Mason Trader trades. So the Wandering Trader can trade 1 emerald for a few small drip leaf and 1 emerald for 2 moss. And a mason, you can trade 1 emerald or 2 emeralds or something for a few pieces of the dripstone block. And there's also a change to the mineshaft and shipwreck loot tables. In mineshafts, in the minecart chests, you can find glowberries, which I actually have to go back and show you because I forgot to show those. And you will also, in the shipwreck chests, you have a chance of finding moss. So that's how you find moss before the new biomes, which will come in 1.18 this holiday season. Infested blocks. It will now take half the time to mine the regular block if it is infested. For example, think of infested stone. That will take half the time to mine as a regular stone block. So it's a little easier to tell if it's regular or infested. Because what it used to be is, if it's infested, if you clicked it, then it would automatically break and spawn a silverfish. And that's a little scary. Dirt paths can now be made by using a shovel on dirt, podzol, mycelium, or coarse dirt, as well as what it used to be, just grass. Drowned, they have a chance of dropping a copper ingot rather than a gold ingot, which kind of makes sense because the trident is made out of copper. You can't craft it, but by the looks of it, it looks like oxidized copper. So tridents, instead of dropping gold, they will drop copper. Experience orbs, they will merge if there's a lot of them, because having a lot of those experience orbs, that's a lot of entities in the world, so it can kind of lag your game. But now they will merge together if there's too many of them, and they will reduce lag. Holding down the space bar now increases the scroll speed in the credits. So if you're going through the end credits after you've defeated the dragon, you've gone in the portal, if you hold down the space bar, it will go through faster. And if you hold down control and the space bar, it will go down even faster. Minecarts and rails can now be waterlogged. They will go through water, but minecarts will be a little slower if they're in water. Particles now appear when pistons break blocks. I'm not going to go through all those small changes, like the differences in the creative menu. Simple firework rockets with one gunpowder, so the flight duration 1 rockets can be made in the recipe book now, so that's good. If you go into the accessibility menu in accessibility settings, you can now change monochrome logo. So if I, change a resource pack, you can see that it is now black instead of the default red. But I like the red, so I think we're going to go ahead and change that back. They've added new achievements, whatever floats your goat, for floating in a boat with a goat. I will give an example because I've never gotten that, and I want to get it, and that would be really cool. So, oak, boat, goat, goat in a boat, me in a boat, whatever floats your goat. Get in a boat and float with a goat. Have fun, sir. Here's a friend. Aw, look at that. Look at that. Wax on is given for putting honeycomb on a copper block, and wax off is scraping wax off of a copper block with an axe. The cutest predator is for catching an axolotl in a bucket, and the healing power of friendship is for teaming up with an axolotl and winning a fight. See, those, if you help an axolotl by killing an enemy that it's going after, like a drowned, then it will give you regeneration for a few seconds, which is actually pretty cool. Glow and behold for making a sign glow, just like that. And light as a rabbit for walking on powder snow with leather boots. Surge protector for having a lightning bolt strike a lightning rod near a villager without setting the area on fire. They added, is it a bird for looking at a parrot through a spyglass? Is it a balloon for looking at a gas through a spyglass? And is it a plane for looking at the ender dragon through a spyglass? Those are the new advancements or achievements, whatever you want to call them. And now I will show you glowberries. This is the last feature I will show you because that's the last feature in 1.17, other than a bunch of bug fixes. One of which I will actually say, you know how you'd go around and sometimes you'd find, you'd find stuff like this, random grass patches in the air. I put those there. You will not be able to find those anymore. They have fixed it. This has been a bug for for so long, and they finally fixed it, and it's so good. Anyways, glowberries. These are cave vines, and you will find them eventually in part 2. But for now, this is part 1, and you will find them in mineshaft minecart chests. You can bone meal them, and they have... Hold on. And they have glowberries, and they make a nice little sound. And you can bone meal them infinitely for lots of glowberries, and they will grow like this, and they look really nice, and when they're like that, they will glow, because they're glowberries. I'll show you, because I'm going to make this area dark. See? If we pick them, now it's dark, and if we grow some more glowberries, it's bright. And it looks very nice, and you can break them and get the glowberries back. But, just saying, if there is a vine, and there's no berries on it, and you break it, you do not get anything. But if you break it with glowberries on it, you will get glowberries. So there are a few more little features, like lightning rods will give off a redstone signal when they're struck by lightning, but I'm not going to get into that because those are little features, and you can always go look at the patch notes, which I will be linking in the description of this video, and you can look at them and you can read all about them. You can read the bug fixes, you can read anything that I haven't covered, like they sorted the creative inventory a little more so that it's more organized, like all the ores are here, the copper's here, but I'm not getting into that today. Ooh, a ruined portal. So that's all for this recap of the Caves and Cliffs update. Part 1 will be on the channel right now. You can go and see it, so I would recommend seeing that. Go watch that, and you will be able to see most of the other blocks and items that are in part 1 of this update. What a nice spawn. So, thank you guys for watching. I know this is not everything in one. We will be getting back to that, but I want to have, you know, more different content on my channel. I don't want just everything in one. That's too much of one thing, and I want to have different things. I want to have diversity in the channel, you know. So, thank you guys for watching. We will be back to everything in one later, and I will see you guys in the next video. Goodbye!